I'm in Cape Cod, Massachusetts, where the wreckage of Black Sam Bellamy's pirate ship was recovered, along with something quite unexpected. A mummy. The mummy had a pistol strapped to its leg by a ribbon. A ribbon that was made by Black Sam's girlfriend, Maria Hallett.
This is the jail where Maria Hallett was jailed at one point for witchcraft.
Do you see this etching right there?
Yes.
Is this a ship?
This ship, carved right beside Maria's cell, raises questions. Did Maria carve this herself as a beacon of hope that her beloved Sam might return? Or was there something else more sinister going on? Sam Bellamy was a British merchant marine who met Maria and fell instantly in love. Because Bellamy was poor, Maria's parents wouldn't let the couple get married. So Bellamy set sail to make a fortune by any means necessary and became a pirate. Soon after he left, Maria discovered she was pregnant with his child. Fearing what would happen if anyone found out, she kept the baby hidden in a barn. And one day, when Maria was out gathering food, her baby choked on straw and died. The locals believed she murdered her own child, and she was accused of witchcraft and jailed. A witch and a pirate.
Maria is the reason this whole thing happened.
Yep, according to every story, he wants to make his fortune so that he can come back and marry her.
Did Maria die in prison?
She escaped three different times.
And they didn't bring her back in?
No.
Where did she end up going then?
There are stories that she ended up with the treasure.
That's really interesting.
That even if he didn't make it off the ship, that anyone who did would have been instructed to bring treasure to Maria.
And what did she do after she got out of prison?
She just went off to the dunes and waited for Bellamy to return.
Where exactly was that spot?
It was right near where the Witta eventually wrecked in Wellfleet, near Marconi Beach.
So she was right there?
She likely saw everything.
Wow.
So the story goes, you know, that she's here in the jail cell on the floor, and then this very well-dressed man comes in to the jail. And all the stories say that it's the devil. He's come to visit her. He lays the way open for her for freedom and to escape. Eventually, she got out so many times that they just let her go, excommunicated her, basically. That was her punishment. She was never put on trial or anything like that. She just went off to the dunes and waited for Bellamy to return. The locals believe that the devil gave her the power to conjure a great nor'easter to bring down the mighty Witta ship and her lover, Sam Bellamy, because she was so angry at what he had done to her and how he had left her.
That's really interesting because it was a freak storm.
Yes.
That storm was not forecasted and shouldn't have happened that time of the year.
Black Sam's pistol has led me to the shores of Marconi Beach to see where Maria Hallett lived and where the Witta washed up. There's intriguing firsthand evidence in the 1724 book, The General History of Pirates, which is considered the definitive primary source on the golden age of piracy. That on the day of the wreck, Sam Bellamy traveled north up the coast with three other ships. In the 2 months prior, he amassed more wealth than any other pirate in history. He was on his way to Maine, where he often went to service his ship. By sunset, there was a dead calm before a dense fog rolled in, separating the four ships at about midnight. A Canadian cold front collided with a Caribbean heat wave directly over the Cape. A 75-mile-per-hour wind and waves up to 40 feet tall hurled the Witta into a sandbar. But the question is, could Black Sam have survived? Kathleen and I are meeting with coastal historian William Burke, who's been researching Black Sam and the Witta wreck for more than 20 years.
know, you had 70-mile-per-hour winds, and the waves were breaking on the beach, and the place was chaos. Wreckage, bodies, treasure.
I was diving the wreck site yesterday. Where is it? About there?
Just a little further up, yes.
The wreck was only 500 feet from shore.
So people on shore would have seen the wreck happen.
And Maria would have been at the top of the bluff and looking out on the scene.
Wow.
This would be a likely spot, perhaps, for Mary Hallett's hut.
How long did Bellamy leave her for?
He was gone for about a year and a half.
Is there any records of them planning that when he comes back, they're gonna do something?
His partner went up to Maine, but Bellamy wanted to come back to the Cape because he was coming back for Maria.
And why Maine?
Because they would usually go up there to clean the ships.
So perhaps Black Sam was on his way to meet his girlfriend and then take her to Maine.
Do ships come this way generally?
There are no safe harbors as we face here facing east. Ships will always be going by here and need another 30 or 40 miles to get around the fist of the Cape for safe harbor. So this was just merely a highway out here.
So it's unclear why a skilled captain would be coming this way in the first place.
Yes.
Doesn't sound right. I have a theory.
Okay.
The wreck happened very close to shore. So close that the divers excavating the widow can swim it.
Right.
I actually think he had just stolen all of this treasure, and the authorities knew it. If Sam Bellamy actually arranged this, faked his own death, then that's why he would have planted his pistol on another pirate. What if Sam Bellamy survived?
I can see that, and that would be great. I mean, that would be a great ending.
We already know that the rest of his sleet went up to Maine.
Just up the coast.
Maybe he went there too.